Continuing now at the top of Daf Peicheslam and Vezim Meseches Shabbos. This is Shabbos Daf 88b. The Gemara here is discussing Rava's response to the Tzeduki as to why Klal Yisrael said Nasa before Nishma. So he says, "Disaginan b'shleimusa k'siv bon." Us, who go b'shleimus with HaKadosh Baruch Hu, it says about us, "Tumas yesharim tanchim." The idea being that those who go straight, they're led. Those who are tamim with Hashem, they're led in the proper direction. Hanoch inshi disagan balilusa k'siv b'hu v'selef bogdim yishadim. And in contrast, those who are always looking for excuses against HaKadosh Baruch Hu, so they are led in that direction. Gemara now continues at the two dots. Amar Rav Shmuel bar Nachmeni, Amar Rav Yonasan. Rav Shmuel bar Nachmeni says in the name of Rav Yonasan, what does the pasuk mean when it says, Libavtani achosi kala, libavtani ba'achas me'inayich? The Gemara darshins b'tchila ba'achas me'inayich. Originally it was with one eye, l'keshet ha'asi b'shtei einayich. And then when you did the mitzvos, it's with two eyes. Rashi here explains, "Bitchila bekabola shekibaltem achas yetzlechem." The idea basically is that when you accepted the Torah, so that was I came close to you with one eye. Ulevesov kishekiyamtem shtayim yesh. And when there was when you accepted the Torah, not just through kabbalah, but you started to be mekayim the Torah, you started to fulfill the Torah, there was two. The Rashi says, "Libavtani is keraftani." I brought you close to me. That's the difference going from one to two. And the Gemara continues, Amar Ula Ula says, Aluva Kala Mizana Besoch Chupasa. Rashi says, Aluva means Chatsufa. It's almost like a chutzpah. Dovena Lishna de Chutzpahi. Vahachi Amar Meseches Gittin, Mizana Besoch Chupasa. Keshi Yisrael, Keshamda Besinai, Vasua Egel. When Klal Yisrael, they were just at Harsinai, they're like a Kala. And right there is when they sin. That's like a Kala. That's Mizana Besoch Chupa. That's Aluva. It's like disgraceful that the way the Klal Yisrael acted right after Matan Torah. Amar Rav Mori, brother Bas Shmuel, Rav Mori, the son of Bas Shmuel, said, "My kra, what is the pasuk which discusses this? Ad shahamelech b'mesibo nerdi." The pasuk says, "Ad shahamelech b'mesibo nerdi." So the idea, again, in that pasuk, is that while the celebration is going on, so then you have this sin. Now the pasuk goes on to say, "Nerdi nasan recho." So the Gemara says, "Amar Rav." Rav says, "Va'adayin chavivusa higabon." Even this pasuk is saying there's still a little bit of chavivus between Klal Yisrael and HaKadosh Baruch Hu, dechsev nasan v'loch kasav hisriach. It doesn't say that the actions of Klal Yisrael during this mesibah, it doesn't say hisriach, which is a very negative connotation that they were spoiled, like the smell is spoiled. It just says nasan. The idea Rashi says nasan is ozav recho, the good smell, ozav recho hatov l'achem, the good smell left for others. So it's even in the situation of Avera, the language that the pasuk uses is a little bit tempered. It's not as strong, as harsh as it could be. Gemara says, "Tana Rabbanan." We learned in a brisa, "Aluvin ve'enon olvin shomen cherpasan ve'enom nishivin." People who are embarrassed by others, but they don't embarrass others. People who hear their own disgrace, but they don't respond. Osin me'ava. They do things out of love. Usmechen biyisurin, and they're happy when they get yisurin. When yisurin come upon them, alein hakasav omer. About such people, the pasuk says, "Vioav," of those who love him. It says Hashemesh Bigvuraso. They are strong, like when the sun comes out in its might. Amar Rabbi Yochanan. Rabbi Yochanan says, "What does the pasuk mean when it says Hashem Yiten Amar Hamevasro Savarav?" It means Kol Dibor VeDibor SheYotza MiPiya Gvura. Each statement that was made from Hakadosh Baruch Hu Nechlek L'Shivim L'Shonos. It gets divided into 70 languages. How does this have anything to do with this pasuk? Rashi here says Savarav Kol HaUmos. The pasuk is referencing the Mevasros, that the news or the statements that HaKadosh Baruch Hu says, they reach Tzavarav, they reach all the nations, the idea being that they split to all 70 languages. Tani Devei Rabbi Yishmael, it was taught in the yeshiva of Rabbi Yishmael, Chafatish Yifutza Sela, it's like a hammer that bangs on the rock. Ma'patish Zen Nechlak L'chamani Tzotzos, just like the hammer causes sparks to go in every direction. Af Kol Dibor V'Dibor Sheyotzmi Pei HaKadosh Baruch Hu, so to every single statement that comes from the mouth of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, Nechlak L'shivim L'shonos, is divided amongst 70 different languages. Amar Rav Chananel Bar Papa. Rav Chananel Bar Papa says, "My dechsiv." What does the pasuk mean when it says "Shimu ki negidim adaber"? It says, "Listen, because negidim is what I'm speaking." Lama nimshalu divrei Torah kinagid. What is this comparison between divrei Torah and leadership? Lomar lach. It's to tell you as follows: "Man nagid ze yeshbo lahamis ulahachios." Just like a leader has the power to kill and to keep alive. Af divrei Torah, so too when it comes to divrei Torah, yesh bam lahamis ulahachios. Divrei Torah can kill and divrei Torah can keep alive. Hainu damar Rava, that's what Rava said. L'mayminin bo asama dechai, for those who are On the right side with Torah, it's a medicine that can bring life. Lamas me'ilimba, those who are on the left side of Torah, meaning they abandon the Torah, sama demosa, can be a poison. Davarach, another explanation of negidim, kol dibor v'dibor sheyotzim ipi HaKadosh Baruch Hu, koshim lo shnei kesarim. We're going here on the plural of negidim, and the idea is that every dibor that came from the mouth of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, as we said before, each person at Har Sinai got two kesarim, they got two crowns, that's the plural, two as opposed to one. The Gemara now continues at the two dots. Amar Rabbi Yehoshua ben Levi. Rabbi Yehoshua ben Levi says, "My dechsiv, what does the pasuk mean when it says Tsror Hamor Do Dili Ben Shaddai Yolin?" Now the word Ben Shaddai Yolin has to do with between the bosoms. So what is this referring to? Amar Knesses Yisrael Efnei Hakadosh Baruch Hu. Knesses Yisrael says before Hakadosh Baruch Hu, Ribono Shel Olam, Afal Pi Shemeitzar Umeimarli Do Di Ben Shaddai Yolin. Rashi explains exactly what we mean. Even though my beloved told me to take off the crowns at the time of the sin of the Egel, Ben Shaddai Yolin, which means Amar Miyad Lasos Lo Mishkan. Immediately after the Egel, we were told to build a Mishkan. Lios Mitzumtzemes Shechinaso Ben Shnei Habadim, that the Shechina would be between the two Badim by the Aron. Sheniru B'Mikdash Rishon Kishnei Shaddayim Dochin Uvolten B'Parochas Keneged HaPesach. The two poles that come out by the Aron, the two badim, they resemble two shadayim. They resemble this area of the bosom, and that's the idea that immediately after the sin, even immediately after the sin, we were told that HaKadosh Baruch Hu would rest his shechina in the Mishkan. The Gemara continues, Eshkol HaKofer Dodi Li Bekarmei Ein Gedi. So, darshaning this pasuk here in Shir HaShirim, what does it mean? Misha Kol Shelo, it means the person who has everything, or the being that has everything, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, mechaper li alavon gedi. The word gedi here, ein gedi, we're darshaning as a goat. The idea being that HaKadosh Baruch Hu forgave us for the sin of the golden calf. Rashi here actually has two explanations of this. Ein gedi, he says, avon egel shu min behema. It could be the sin of the egel, because it's a kind of animal. Lashon acher, lashon avodah zara. Ha'orchim la'god shulchan. Sometimes the word god is used to mention it to mean avodah zara. And the Gemara continues, "Mechaper li alavon gedi shekaramti li," that Hakadosh Baruch Hu forgave me for the sin of the ego, which I gathered. Rashi here says, "Shekaramti sheasafti lesavos alos harbe." I gathered many different idols. K'dichsiv eila lohecha Yisrael, like the pasuk says, "These are your gods, Israel." So the sins of the many idols, those were forgiven by Hakadosh Baruch Hu. Now, my mashma the haikarmi lishna demachneshu. How do we know that the word karmi means to gather? Amar Marzutra Breda Rav Nachman, Marzutra, the son of Rav Nachman, says, Kiritanan, like we learned in the Mishnah, Kisei Shalkovis Shekarmim Olav Esakelim. They used to put the clothing, the person who used to wash the clothing, he used to gather the clothing on the table. Rashi here says, Shekarmim Olav, Shema'asman Olav Esabigadim Vudaf Arucha. They used to have a long board, Nukheves Nekavim Harbe, and it had a lot of holes in it. Umeiniach HaMugmar Tachta, and there would be the Mugmar, which was this sweet-smelling item which burned. It was underneath the board. V'hakelem misgamrin miderech hanakavim. And the person who washed the clothing would put the clothing on this platform, on this daf, and then the smell would come up, and that's how he would make the clothing smell good. The Gemara now continues at the two dots. V'yomer Rabbi Yehoshua ben Levi. Rabbi Yehoshua ben Levi says, Ma'ay dechsiv, what does the pasuk mean when it says, L'choyev karugas habosam. So the pasuk says that its cheeks are like the arugas habosam. What does that mean? Kol dibor v'dibor sheyotzim mipi HaKadosh Baruch Hu. It means that it's referring to the speech of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Every dibor that came from HaKadosh Baruch Hu, nismalei kol ha'olam kula besamim. The whole world was filled with the smell, with sweet-smelling spices. So the Gemara asks, v'kevan shemi dibor rishon nismalei, but if the entire world was filled from the first dibor of the Aseres HaDibros, dibor sheni le'echan olach. So how is the smell going to, it's already filled up. What's the second dibor going to do? So the Gemara says, Hotzei HaKadosh Baruch Hu haruach me'otrosav. HaKadosh Baruch Hu took out the wind from his storehouses via ma'avir rishon. And he would have one, Rashi explains, he'd have the first fragrance would be blown off into Gan Eden, and the second one would come. Shenemar, like it says, Sifsosav shoshanim notvos mor avar, al tekre shoshanim ela shoshonim. Instead of reading it shoshanim, it's shoshonim, it repeats. Meaning, with each dibor, HaKadosh Baruch Hu repeated this process, moving the good smell off to Gan Eden and bringing a new one in its place. And the Gemara continues at the two dots. V'yamar Rabbi Yehoshua ben Levi. Rabbi Yehoshua ben Levi says, "Kol dibor v'dibor sheyotzim mipi HaKadosh Baruch Hu." With every dibor that came from the mouth of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, yotzta nishmasan shal Yisrael. The Klal Yisrael as a whole, they all died. Then their neshamas left them. Shenemar, like it says, "Nafshi yotzta bedabro that, again, my soul left with the speech. So the Gemara asks, if from the first dibor the neshama has already left, dibor sheni hech kibla, how do they receive the second dibor? So the Gemara answers, he brought down the dew, which is going to be used for tchias ha-mesim, v'hachiyosam, and he brought them back to life, shenemar, like it says in the pasuk, geshem nedavos tanif elokim nachalascha v'nila osak honanta. So the reference there to geshem at the time of Matan Torah, Rashi says, so that's a reference to this dew, which brings the tchias ha-mesim. V'yomar Rabbi Yoshua ben Levi, and Rabbi Yoshua ben Levi says, kol dibor v'dibor shiyotzam ipi HaKadosh Baruch Hu chazru Yisrael achorein yud beiz mil. With every dibor that HaKadosh Baruch Hu spoke, Klal Yisrael went back 12 mil. And the malachim would move them along and bring them back to the mountain. Shenemar, like it says, malachim tzavakos yidudun yidodun altekri yidodun eli yididun. Rashi explains here, yidodun mashmahim atzum yidodun. They moved. Yididun madidun achim. They moved others. So you read it that way, it means that they moved Klal Yisrael up back towards the mountain. The Gemara continues at the two dots. V'yamar Rabbi Yoshua ben Levi. Rabbi Yoshua ben Levi says, b'shasha ala Moshe lamarim, when Moshe went up to the heavens, Amru malachi ha'asharis lefnei HaKadosh Baruch Hu, the malachim said to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, ribono shelo lamal yulud isha beinenu. What is the child of a woman, what is a human doing amongst us? Amru lehen, so he said to them, lekabel Torah, but he's coming to receive the Torah. Amru lefanav, they said to him, chamudo genuzo shegenuzo loch teisha meos v'shivim v'arba adoros. This beloved thing which has been with you for 974 generations, Kodem Shenivra Olam, before the world was even created, Atom Evakesh Linna Labasar Vadam, you want to give this to a human? Mo Enosh Kisiz Karenu Ven Adam Kisif Gedenu. What are humans that you should be remembering them in this way? Hashem Adonenu Moad Yershimcha Bechol Oretz Asher Tanahodcha Al Hashamayim. Amar La Kodesh Baruch Hu, Kodesh Baruch Hu said back, Lamoshe, he said to Moshe, Hechzer Lan Shuva, give them a response, tell them why humans are fit to receive the Torah. Amar lefan of Ribono Shel Olam, Mesiarei Ani Shema Yisrafuni Behevel Shebefiyem. So Moshe said, Ribono Shel Olam, I'm afraid that I'm going to be burned with the breath of their mouths. Amar Elohi said to him, Achuz Bekisei Kavodi V'chazer Lan Shuva, grab my holy throne, my honorable throne, and give them a response. Shenemar, like it says, Me'achuz Pnei Kisei Parshaz Aleinu Anono, that he spread the cloud from his throne that protected Moshe Rabbeinu. V'yomar Reb Nachum, and Reb Nachum said, Melamed Shapir Shakai Miziv Shchinaso V'Anano Olav. The idea of the pasuk is that Shapir is Shakai, that HaKadosh Baruch Hu spread from his Shchina and was like a cloud over Moshe Rabbeinu. Amar Lefanav, Ribono Shel Olam, Torah Shata Nosen Limach Sibba. So Moshe said, Ribono Shel Olam, the Torah you're giving to me, what's written there? So he said, Anochi Hashem Elokecha, Asher Otzeisicha Me'eretz Mitzrayim. He quoted in the first pasuk of the Aseres Hadibros. Amar Leni, so he said to them, to the angels, L'Mitzrayim Yeratem, did you go down to Mitzrayim? L'Paro Hishtabadetem, were you servants to Paro? Torah Lama Tehelechem, what should the Torah have anything to do with you? Shuv Maksiba, what else is written there? Lo Yelecha Elohim Acherim, so it says, don't have other gods from the nations that surround you. So Moshe Rabbeinu said to the angels, Bein Amim Atem Shruim, are you living amongst the other nations, Sheovdin, that they worship? And the Gemara will continue with this story. And Daf Pei Tes Amar Aleph, we'll see that in the next video.